Is this thing on? Testing, testing. Okay, it's on. Hello, guys. Welcome to Jellybees Phase 2. I really don't know what I'm going to be getting into here. Well, I watched the trailer. So anyways, let's see. Of course there's no... Like, why couldn't they make a non-full screen setting? Alright, I hope you guys can hear it well.
Hello? How's it going? I'm sorry you had to fill in for my night shifts. You probably heard about the new shipments that just came in today. They came from the Jollibee's restaurant right across the street.
Alright.
It's a shame they had to close down for some reason. I heard that something was stinging up the place and they had to shut it down because of health code violations. Animatronics had to be shipped for investigation. This is where we come in. Don't worry. I'll guide you along the way. As long as you don't damage the shipments, nobody will get in trouble. This is the warehouse management interface. This is basically the control panel for the entire facility. In this screen, you can buy upgrades or work on extra jobs to increase the warehouse's stats. But you don't have to worry about that for now. Once you're ready, click the button.
Click what button? Here we go, guys. Night one.
Okay, so first things first. Your job as a night shift guard is to make sure that the shipments go to their proper couriers. You can do this by heading over to the left side of the office and opening the workstation panel.
Okay.
The left side of the screen is the conveyor belt module. You turn it on, it's going to bring in boxes that you need to put onto their corresponding tracks. You can switch the track that the boxes will lead to by clicking and dragging the nodes to their tracks.
Turn off the conveyor belt system. Okay. I assume we gotta... What do I do? Oh, now I see what to do. Okay. Okay, so I click and drag. I kind of see what to do now, but how is this going to tie into the survival?
Great! You're getting the hang of it. You can turn it off for now, but remember to turn it on after I oriented you. on the right side of the screen is where you'll see the security module. This is where you'll be able to... monitor what's going on with the facility. You can use the motion detectors and the cameras to keep track of what's going on, but I'd stick to the motion detectors if I were you. The cameras do have a lot of blind spots around the facility, especially in the conveyor belts. And if any of the systems go offline for any reason, you can use the maintenance panel on the far right side of the office. I'll leave everything to you now. Just don't mess anything up so no one gets fired. Alright, good luck.
I'm kind of scared.
You have 1 new voicemail to listen to your messages. Press 1.
Hello, and thank you for accepting our shipments in line with the inspection that will occur in our establishments. This voice memo is offered to you as a reminder on how to guard our animatronic robots while they're waiting to be shipped. The animatronics cannot be turned off for diagnostic reasons. As such, they are programmed to find the nearest room occupied by people for maximum entertainment value. To make sure they don't run into your office and cause trouble, you can use the company-issued audio alert mechanism, which you can find installed in your system's workstation panel under the security tab. If you'd like to take extra precaution, you can control the animatronics momentarily by clicking the hack button to view the hacking module. Please keep in mind that the effects of the hacking mechanism are expected to wear off momentarily, as the robot's firewall feature will block you from taking control temporarily. If the animatronics are somehow able to find their way in front of you, you can shine your light into their faces, causing them to do a system restart. If that doesn't work, please make use of any office instructions like hiding under your desk until they go away. Do not tamper with the animatronic robots, as we will not hesitate on suing your establishment for any damages found on the units. Thank you for your cooperation.
I'm a little scared. Please tell me that this is just going to be like FNAF 3 Night 1. Let's reboot. I haven't used audio yet. Reboot the cameras. How do I know when it's safe to... How do I know when it's safe to... I don't see anyone. I just gotta keep doing this until, like, I got all the boxes. Thank you. I'm like really freaking out, you guys. I don't see anything in the cameras. Where is that? So far there aren't any. I'm gonna use an audio. Oh, that tells me where they're going. Scared. How long do they survive for? Let's reboot the cameras. See any animatronics. I assume I just gotta do this until until like I can get them out, the right amount of these crates. Okay. Yeah. Damn it. This is still... It's still recording. Popo was there. At least it tells me how I gotta beat him. I really hope that the video recording, like, caught the audio stuff, but seriously, Popo... What was I supposed to do? Okay, shine your light in a timely fashion to make him go away. I was checking to see if he was there. Okay, well, it looks like all I can do is the crate. So now I have somewhat of an idea of what to do. Wait a minute. Okay. I'll try again. At least now I have somewhat of an idea of what to do.
Okay, so first things first. Your job as a night shift guard is to make sure that the shipments go to their proper couriers. You can do this by heading over to the left side of the office and opening the workstation panel. The left side of the screen is the conveyor belt module. You turn it on, it's going to bring in boxes that you need to put onto their corresponding tracks. You can switch the track that the boxes will lead to by clicking and dragging the nodes to their tracks. Great! You're again the hang of it. You can turn it on for now, but remember to turn it on after I've oriented you. On the right side of the screen is where you'll see the security module. This is where you'll be able to, monitor what's going on with the facility. You can use the motion detectors and the cameras to keep track of what's going on, but I'd stick to the motion detectors if I were you. Cameras do have a lot of blind spots around the facility, especially at the conveyor belts. And if any of the systems go offline for any reason, you can use the maintenance panel on the far right side of the office. Okay, I'll leave everything to you now. Just don't mess anything up so no one gets fired, all right? All right, good luck. You have 1. Your voicemail. To listen to your messages, press 1.
Hello, and thank you for accepting our shipments in line with the inspection that will occur in our establishment. This voice memo is offered to you as a reminder on how to guard our animatronic robots while they're waiting to be shipped. The animatronics cannot be turned off for diagnostic reasons. As such, they are programmed to find the nearest room occupied by people for maximum entertainment value. To make sure they don't run into your office and cause trouble, you can use the company-issued audio alert mechanism, which you can find installed in your system's workstation panel under the security tab. If you'd like to take extra precaution, you can control the animatronics momentarily by clicking the hack button to view the hacking module. Please keep in mind that the effects of the hacking mechanism are expected to wear off momentarily, as the robot's firewall feature will block you from taking control temporarily. If the animatronics are somehow able to find their way in front of you, you can shine your light into their faces.
The problem is, I didn't see Popo there, and I was like,
if that doesn't work, please make use of any office obstructions, like hiding under your desk, until they go away. Do not tamper with the animatronic robots, as we will not hesitate on suing your establishment for any damages found on the units. Thank you for your cooperation.
I'm sorry, I'm not, like, talking, guys. I'm just in mega focus right now. Scare noises weren't that bad. That's one thing. Audio. Let's lower it over here. Oh. Let me out of here. Probably just stick with the motion detector. And like, I can't like quickly switch off anything. When Popo is there, that's the thing. Dang it, well. Looks like I'll have to leave the game running for a little bit. Okay, hang on, I need to pause the recording. Which one was... Okay, that's not working.